RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to solve some density practice problems. Density is often one of the very first formulas you use in chemistry, and so it's good to kind of use as a practice to know how to do some algebraic solving. And so our formula is D equals M over V, and let's go ahead and solve this first problem. So we're using density, mass, and volume. So basically density is just saying, you know, how dense are you? Are you like a gold bar where you're super heavy even though you take up a tiny amount of space? Or are you like cotton candy where you take up a ton of space but you don't have very much mass at all? And so our first problem, what's the density of a statue that has a mass of 632 kilograms and a volume of 4.2 liters? So we're always going to use this same formula of D equals M over V. And so in this case, we're given the mass, 632 kg. We're given the volume, 4.2 liters. So in our formula, which will always be the same, we have mass, we can check that off, and we have volume, check that off. We're solving for density. So in this case, we don't have to do any algebra because D is already solved for. It's completely by itself in the formula. We can just go ahead and plug in. So plugging in, we put our mass on top, our volume on the bottom, and going ahead and solving, we get to 150.48 before units and sig figs. Looking at our sig figs, we have 3 for 632 and 2 for 4.2. So we're going to end up with 2 sig figs, which rounds to 150 with no decimal point. And so the units are going to be kg per liter. All right, and so now I want to go ahead and go over this little pyramid that's right here. So this pyramid is kind of a way to avoid algebra. And so I don't recommend that. I'm going to be annoying and keep on saying that. I recommend always doing the algebra, but I wanted to include it as an option because I know some students really prefer this method when they are really, really struggling with algebra. So if you have, you know, a test tomorrow and your back is against the wall and you just can't learn algebra right now, you can memorize this pyramid. And so the way that it works is that whatever you're solving for, you go ahead and you cross out. So in this case, we're looking for density, so we just go ahead and cross it out. And then the rest of the pyramid reveals to you what the formula should be. So we can see it looks like M divided by volume. So we can see that this line in the middle represents division, and then we can see on the numerator it's going to be mass, on the denominator it's going to be volume. And so that will end up with the same formula we end up using. So next, what's the mass of a silver bar if it has a volume of 0.841 centimeters cubed and silver has a density of 10.5 grams per centimeters cubed? So we're always going to use our same formula, D equals M over V, and let's check off our checks and question our question mark. We're asked, what's the mass? That's our question mark, that's our unknown, and we're told the volumes, we have that, and we have the density. So in this case, we are going to have to do algebra because we need mass completely solved by itself before we can go ahead and plug in. So rearranging so that D looks like a fraction, we have D over 1 equals M over V. And now to go ahead and get rid of V, we can multiply by V over 1 on both sides. Now we can cancel out V, and we're left with V times D equals mass. And now to go ahead and use the pyramid to show you how to do it, we go ahead and cross out what we're looking for. That was mass, and now that reveals the formula, which is D times V. Same thing as V times D equals M. So now we can go ahead and plug in. So we can plug in our volume, 0.841 centimeters cubed, times our density, 10.5 grams per centimeters cubed. So our answer is 8.83. We can go ahead and cross out centimeters cubed, and we can see that our units is in grams. We're solving for mass, so that checks out. All right, so last but not least, let's solve this one on the bottom. What's the volume of a cube with a density of 53.1 grams per centimeters cubed and a mass of 12.90 kg? So same formula, density equals mass over volume. So we're looking for volume. We have the density, we have the mass, same formula, density equals mass over volume. So redrawing, we have D over 1 equals M over V. And now I'm going to go ahead and get rid of mass by multiplying by 1 over m on both sides. So we can cancel out m on the right-hand side. The left-hand side ends up being d over m, and then we have that equals 1 over v. Now we can't solve for 1 over v. That's not finished algebra. We have to solve for v, which is the same as v over 1. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is just flip both sides of the fraction, and I'm going to end up with m over d equals v over 1, which is the same as just v. All right, so now let's go ahead and use the pyramid. So in this case, we are looking for volume. So we can go ahead and scratch that one out. And that reveals to us that our formula is m divided by d. Okay, last time I'm going to nag you. Just remember that this pyramid is not really learning how to do algebra, and you're going to get many more formulas. This is not a good permanent solution to do these types of problems. And plus, if you memorize it wrong at all, you're going to get every single problem wrong. But for right now, let's go ahead and plug in our mass and our density. So we get 12.90 kg over 53.1 grams per centimeters cubed. And now we can see we're not going to be able to cancel out because we have kilograms for our mass and our density involves grams. So those don't cancel out. So we actually can't plug in right now. What we're going to have to do is do a conversion. So I think it's going to be easiest if we convert kilograms to grams, and then we can go ahead and plug in. So if you don't know how to do unit conversions, check out my videos on them. But for right now, we need to just take 12.90 kg. We need to cancel out kg, that goes on the bottom, which means grams goes on the top. 1 kg equals 1,000 grams, so our final answer is 12,900 grams. Kg gets canceled out. Now we can go ahead and plug in to our equation that's solved for volume. So 12,900 grams over 53.1 grams per centimeters cubed. Now checking for sig figs, we have 3 sig figs, 53.1, and 4 sig figs, 12.90, which means our limitation is 3 sig figs. So plugging in, we have, before sig figs, we have 242.938 centimeters cubed, and now going ahead and rounding to 3 sig figs, we end up with 243 centimeters cubed for our final answer. All right, hope this video explained how to do some density practice problems. Classes can range from either this is about how hard all of them can be to getting a lot harder than this. But no matter how hard they get, it's always the same concept. You want to come back to your density formula, d equals m over v, and you know that your teacher has to have given you a way to solve for 2 out of 3 variables, and then you can plug in and get your third variable. All right, good luck and happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks. That's it. Happy studying.